All right, and we're back. Bruce has been thinking while he's been smoking. A few things linger in his mind. Like these escaped synths that he's supposedly tracking down. He's gonna have to murder Bunker Hill, basically, to execute. It almost feels like a whim that he's been sent here, almost. Like, they'll be missing for months from the sounds of it, and like, he's seen all these synths that they have in the Institute. Like, they make them pretty quickly. Like, he had to look around in that synth making lab. They just put them together and like, no worries. So why are these ones, why do they care about getting these ones back? And is it worth, like, killing people he kind of likes? And the ultimate answer is no. Like, Bruce has some parental loyalty to his son. Like, he's not gonna, like, betray him or anything like that. Not gonna, like, destroy the Institute or anything crazy like that. But, at the same time, yeah, this deed is not... He's not down with it. He's not okay with it. He's not gonna condone it. Like, this is exactly the kind of shit that the Institute pulls, which has gotten such a bad rep. They earned them such a bad rep. So now comes the thought, if he doesn't do it, this courser is going to go ahead and do it anyway. He's going to go and murder all those people that Bruce kind of likes. Like, not hugely likes, but this is a useful spot. This is of use to Bruce. This is a whole bunch of vendors, a whole bunch of... They got water. They let him in there and drink the water and fill up his water bowls, and they got food in there and all that kind of stuff. He's not okay with having it just disappear like that. So, what we're gonna do is just give it the old wacky whack. So we can't have him go in there either. Let's just take his stuff. Let's we're gonna drag this body out. It sounds like vertebirds are shooting something nearby. Anyway, we're just going to drag that. Let's put it in there. I think this is for the best, I think. Just pop you in there with the other... I mean, Bruce doesn't feel bad killing this synth thing. It's ultimately, it's just a robot. As everyone's happy to point out. Underneath it's probably like what, metal and stuff. It's just basically a funky little Terminator. So no qualms there. Who's that? Wow. More or less. Well, it's for 10-7 there. Oh. There's a bit of a fight going on there. Okay. Bruce is gonna go AWOL for a little while. He's gonna pretend that he isn't there. Now the little quest log says to go meet father, but... Okay, I think what's happened here is... Looks like... Since I've started the siege anyway, which is what Bruce kind of feared. And it looks like the Brotherhood have come in to destroy the synths. So Bruce doesn't need to get involved in that. He's not going to, like, you know, one synth to kill. There's no problem. He can get away with that. He feels like no one's going to, like, we saw you there, blah, 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 blah. Yeah, whatever you have to do. Oh, yeah, we've got this little quest to do, don't we? Huh. Never mind. But he's not going to do anything quite so open as just attacking synths wholesale. Funky little Gen 2 creatures. But he's gonna have to make up some funky story. He's gonna have to take a bit of time away until stuff cools down. There's one thing which crosses his mind. Is that sold Nick Valentine? Now, he used Nick Valentine quite recently to hack a certain computer, which he couldn't. Let's get him in the good graces of the Brotherhood of Steel. And Nick Valentine, he wasn't too thrilled about that all round. Like, he doesn't want to be anywhere near the Brotherhood, because they're all anti-synth, and he's kind of a synth. He felt a bit put out by that, and Bruce recognizes that. And apparently Valentine's got a case. Which was kind of asked, you know, old Brewster, give him a hand with, because he likes the company, I think. He likes the company. That's okay. So, for a bit of time away, a bit of time till the heat cools down once again. Funny how that happens. We're gonna go see what this case is. So, we're gonna meet you up in Diamond City, inside the old detective house. Good old Diamond City. This place is a bit strange, but, you know, it's alright. It's alright. The people mostly aren't a bunch of cunts. Mostly. It's one thing he got at the Institute was this feeling of smugness. They're all bloody scientists to a T. Like, typical stereotypes. Yep, it's, who's a client?
Who's our client?
A fisherman, whose family lives on the edge of the Commonwealth. Kenji Nakano.
Nakano? Huh. That name takes me back. My memory's a little fuzzy on the details, though.
Maybe if you bothered writing things down, Nick.
Can't do that. Wouldn't want to put you out of a job.
Huh. I'll remember that the next time you need me to...
I think a robot would have a perfect memory.
Mr. Nakano didn't leave any details.
Maybe not. It's got to be efficient in how they store stuff.
But if you want my guess, missing,
missing person. Alright.
Guy had a worried look a mile long.
Is the fedora and trench coat mandatory when solving these cases? Because I'm thinking smoking pipe and British accent.
Hey, whatever floats.
Shame you didn't try a British accent there.
The Nakano residence is up in the northeast, near the coast. A small fishing house. He said that he and his wife will be waiting for you.
It's a long walk. That's how the hard cases always start.
Alright, I assume you're coming with.
Nick.
Time to hit the road?
Yep.
Let's head out.
Well, alright.
Who was that? Oh, just some kid. Oh, speaking of which, we left a whole bunch of stuff on old Valentine, so might as well grab that while we're at it.
Hi, I found something when I was going through Paul's things. See what you make of it.
Oh,
okay, show me.
Look at this old
photograph. I seem to be headless. Oh, there it is. Oh, cool. Bunch of combat armor. Looks like guns of some kind. Is that a sawn-off shotgun, maybe? Guy's got a combat rifle. Cool. I seem to be headless and limbless. That's a worry.
An old photo of Paul. Big deal.
An old photo of Paul, Henry Cook, and Malcolm Latimer. And do you know what they're standing in front of?
Why don't you tell me what's so interesting?
Why don't you tell me what's so interesting about this?
I got no idea.
Oh my god. You really don't know. You're not from around here, are you? That's Murawski's old chem warehouse in Quincy. Back when he was the biggest gangster around. 20 years ago, somebody knocked over his warehouse and took everything. Murawski put out a huge bounty on whoever did it, but never caught them. I had no idea that Paul was in on the Murawski heist. My Paul. I can't believe
it. How did she come to that conclusion? I guess, Malcolm Laminar would hate for Murawski to see this picture. Oh, I see. So it was old Paul, it was Cookie, and this, the father of the drug-dealing son.
Come on already.
Shut up, you bitch. Who hit up Murawski. Murawski, that was a dude in a hotel back in Good Neighbor. Remember we, yeah, he had a goon. Interesting. And Malcolm Latimer. He wasn't actually too...
What are you waiting for?
Keen on us, because we kind of killed his son a wee bit.
I guess Malcolm Latimer would hate for Murawski to see this picture.
Mm-hmm. This is my golden ticket. I've got to support my son somehow. I figure you get the best deal you can from one of them, and we split the take.
Okay. Now that I have the photo, I can just keep everything. Do you have a preference on how we handle this?
Do you have a preference how I handle this?
No, I'm just looking for a payday.
Jolly good. You've got a deal.
Got a deal.
I knew when I first met you that this was your kind of thing.
Hell yeah.
I'm good at reading people that way.
Well done, you. Okay, we still got our head. Still got our heads. Had me worried there for a minute.
Hey, I'll see what I can do.
Yep, I gave him a whole bunch of junk from ages the shit back. I'll trade that for some ammo.
Well, ain't that a blast from the past?
5mm ammo, it's not that much of a blast. Okay, so we can go and blackmail Morawski. Let's go give that a shot. See what that does. Not Morawski, the other one. The old jackass. The father.
I may have been programmed to serve, but in your case, I shall do so disdainfully. Let me know when you're ready to order.
Actually, ours. No, I thought maybe you'd have some info. Colonial Tap House, this will happen. Technically. If I can have Valentine wait outside while I just take all the stuff. Will he get pissy if I steal? That's a pain. I'm trying to find Malcolm dude. Codman Richardson. Don't know who that is. Codman Residence. Latimer Residence. Alright, let's see what's in here. There he is. Alright. Let's go have a chat with this fellow.
I found an old photograph of you. I thought you might want it back.
What? Those idiots. Yes, of course. Please. I'd like to see it.
How much do you think Morawski would pay me for this photo?
Why trek all the way to Good Neighbor when I could just pay you for the photo right now? Let's say, 400 caps?
I'll have to think about it.
Don't be a fool. You're walking away from 400 caps. Cash. Right now.
Let's see what Morawski would give us for it. I was hoping that I could get the caps out of him and hold on to the photo somehow. Maybe deal with both, but let's just let him stew for a little while. Maybe when we come back he'll have a better price. I mean, 400 caps is pretty much pocket change at this point. I gotta get that pretty much every time I go to the old vendors to sell off the crap. Even with like no charisma, just selling stuff, you'll get loads of caps. We've got plenty of caps at the moment. Which is bloody hell. Absolute madman. Just keep an eye on that thing, I think it's pretty gonna suddenly explode, isn't it? For bloody Pete's sake. It's Brotherhood bloody kamikaze pilots, my gosh. Let's go see if they had anything good on them. You never know. Alright. Wipe yourself off, you'll be dead. Is that how it goes? Wipe yourself off, you're dead. Yeah. Bruce is trying to quote a movie. Doesn't remember it very well. Another one crashed down here. Bomber jacket. Everything's just blowing up. There he is. Just stay away from the area. Just stay away. Now what on earth were they shooting at, I wonder? Here's another one. And another one.
That sound, what is it?
Did we get them all? Get them all? I think we might have. Ooh, the guy had a minigun. I'll take you. Alright, I think we got them all. And a missile launcher. Well done, you. Well done. Must be that. I think I saw... Well, 5mm. Yes! Here we go. Nothing terribly useful. I was hoping there'd be fusion cores. Never mind. It's Brotherhood guys. I don't know. I'm glad we didn't stick with them too long, because they seem straight up out of their minds. They clearly have no regard for their own lives, or probably anyone else's. And now we've got 1,400 rounds of 5mm. Okay, anyway, so we've got this Nakano residence. Oh, that's right, the Morowski heist. Yeah, travel to the Nakano residence. Where is that? So we want to drop by a good neighbor on the way, so hopefully it's in the start. Yeah, it is. Stretch. Ooh. It's a long way in that direction. Oh my gosh. So if we go to Good Neighbor, see what kind of price Morowski would give us, then we just slip across the river, up this way. Basically, just follow, get onto this main road, follow it all the way north. All the way north. Okay. Look at another level, actually. Let's pop into that. Alright, that seems pretty reasonable. Reasonable speaking, kinda. Although before we go, actually, let's grab some gear. A few things I want to pick up. The ash mech for starters, because now I've got loads of 5mm ammo. So I'm just gonna skip back to pretty just being good neighbor, unless something happens.
Lowest place in the Commonwealth. Everything not nailed down rolls through here at some point.
Well, as Nick just said, we're in Good Neighbor. And I recently remembered, when I went and checked all my locations, that I left the Ashmaker up in the Pridwin. So, we're going to have a stop there, just quietly sneaking out, on our way north. Otherwise, precisely the reason we came here was Morowski. So let's just pop in here. See what he'll offer us for a hypothetical little piece of paper. Let's just, see up here somewhere? Now that's Darwin Marvin. Oh, here we go.
Morowski. Hey, Morowski. I have something you might want, if the price is right.
Let's drag him out of here. That'll probably cost me 1,000 caps right there.
You better not be wasting my time.
Hey, did you ever catch the guys that stole all those chems from you 20 years ago?
Are you jerking my chain? Everybody knows I never caught those guys. but don't think I've given up. I won't ever give up. Why? You know something about that?
This seems like the guy I want to talk to.
What would it be worth to you if I did?
That depends on what you know, and if you can prove it or not. Quit stalling. Do you know something or not?
Maybe. I have a photograph that I might sell you, if the price was right.
Oh, let me see this photo and I'll tell you what I'll pay for.
Why would you pay me after you've seen the photo?
Why would you pay me after you'd seen the photo?
If this is what you say it is, I'll be happy to pay you. But I gotta see it first.
Not until we agree on a price.
No, I've had too many jokers trying to sell me information for too many years. I see it first or no deal.
Okay, but if he just me, I'm gonna shoot you.
Look.
Holy fucking shit. Pembroke. Cook and Latimer? Those fucking assholes. I guess Cook got his already. Here's your reward. Worth every cap. I've been waiting for this day for a very long time. If you're looking to make some more off of this thing, there's now some payback to deal out. Interested?
Sure. I didn't realize we were pimping ourselves out as guns for hire now.
Good. And, go ahead and make it as messy as you want.
Nah, we're gonna burn a pick with that guy, so that's cool. Shame on looks around. But didn't seem right to leave him outside. I probably should have in hindsight. Should have left him outside. Bruce doesn't like to, take kindly to being threatened to, which is what old Lannister did. And Bruce has a gut feeling those trigger men who turned up in Diamond City that one time probably wasn't a coincidence. The last little thing we want to do, something we should have done a long time ago, but didn't think of it at the time, I guess you could say, is I'm just going to drop off these two things. Let's put them somewhere, somewhere nice and proper. There. There you go. Old Kent. Yeah, we're gonna borrow his bed. No fiction, really. Okay, let's get going. That was all we wanted to do. Just a quick stop. Bit of a sentimental bit of nonsense, but, you know, seemed appropriate. And we've got no use for that suit anyway. Do we leave anything in here? No, we haven't. Good as gold. Right, now we just need to head north up towards the Brotherhood blimp. Let's see who the hell is shooting at me. Really? Just the one guy? Got some stones.
Oh, someone should make use of it.
That's the dog.
What was that?
Bunch of bloody raiders walking back by the sounds of it. Never mind them, let's just hightail it while we can. Keep an eye out for those super units. Oops, jump. Where are we headed? In the right direction? Yes, just straight ahead of us is the... Jeez Louise. It sounds like it's coming from... Yeah, what's going on here? some idiot raider. Got myself killed. Alright, never mind. Right, so over the bridge. Theoretically, we could just jump in the water and swim across. It is an option. It's probably the fast thing to do, actually. Now, I don't have Aqua Boy, but what we do have is solar powered. I think we've been this way, actually. Have we been this way? I don't think so. No, we haven't.
There's something out there.
Raiders. Definitely raiders.
Hey! Oh, hell no!
We're in for it now!
Just a couple of them. What did this guy have? Ah, just some sentinels, right raider leg, not worth picking up. Yeah, take the gun for the ammo. Okay, no problems there. It's not gonna worry about the rest of them. Oh, what's over here? Looks like a crashed video bird. Fusion cores, 4 fusion cores, that's actually quite welcome, because the old Gatling laser runs on fusion cores, and we've got some funky power armor. Okay.
Hey,
I'm all ears.
Think you can unlock that terminal?
Can do.
Give it a shot anyway. Not too worried if you can't.
Open for business.
Well done. See what it is anyway. There's some T-51. I think for the moment we'll just take the fusion core, call it a day. As far as that's concerned, the video bird, we can just, the video bird, the blimp. Just, it's a bit filthy, but it's only for a short stretch. Hopefully we don't get sick from this. There we go. But actually, because of solar powered, our rads should, in the sunlight, Rocco sales and super center. That's interesting. But let's try and keep on track for once. Hopefully the rads should, what's the phrase? Dissipate? Pretty quickly. We can't actually tell because we can't see our health meters, but okay, I'm gonna get old Valentine to wait here. Oof. Stuff's a bit wrecked, isn't it? I guess it doesn't really matter if they've got this little stuff, all this technology, because they can't actually get into the Institute without the codes.
Hey, what's the plan?
Wait there.
I'll stay put.
Don't want to drag him into the middle of a Brotherhood base, then. Probably get us both shot. Bruce is keeping his head down. Tipping the old fedora. Maybe we should have won the power armor. Keep him to the shadows. No, no, we came and went. Alright. Just quick in and out. No need to speak to anyone. Now it's a missing persons case.
Raider activity. All leave requests to off-base sites have been temporarily suspended.
Oh, we've got a lot of stuff in here. There we go. Ashmaker. Now this kind of case that we're heading into, we don't really know a huge amount about it. Other than it's a missing persons. The thing is, even if it is like a 5-minute case and it turns out that this missing person is like hiding in a broom cupboard, Bruce is still keeping a low profile. He's gonna be away for a while. That's why he's picking up all the gear. Like, The minigun and the Gatling laser is probably overkill. But Bruce is considering this to be a bit of an extended trip. Like, even if this mini-person case turns out to be, absolutely nothing happened. You know, what's the phrase? Wild goose chase.
Hey, come on.
There's something you need?
Actually, tell you what.
Here's what I've got.
Here you go. Why don't you equip that? Have a few rounds. On me. Okay, now we just need to head straight north, just shy away from the Brotherhood, shy away from anyone who might recognize us. I would have liked to have stopped off at the old Brotherhood vendor. They have some nice stuff. Pretty good spot for 5mm ammo, actually. But didn't want to risk him recognizing us, so gave it a miss. Yeah, I think we're just passing Easy City Downs. Yeah, Easy City Downs. Didn't notice it slime before. Huh. Bit of a ghost town now. Well, possibly literally. Bruce isn't really the superstitious type. But at the same time, if he comes across a ghost, he'll be like, yep, that's a ghost, okay. And he'll probably be wary of it ever after. But he hasn't seen a ghost so far in his life. So he's optimistic that maybe he won't see one in the near future. Fingers crossed. Flickering sign, let's just assume that it's metallic. Well done, Nick. Tried to burn all the ammo at once though. Frag grenade. Book return tokens. Take your goggles as well. Okay, we don't need to pick fights with raiders just yet. Well, that could be fun. Chain door. Should we jump up here? Oof, poor doggy, but I'll take a bandana. Yeah. More fusion core is beautiful. Sort of thinking maybe I should give him a Gatling laser instead. Yeah, I might do that. Give it fusion core. Doesn't really matter if he burns through that, it's only half a fusion core, just weighing us down anyway. Whereas 10mm ammo is not necessarily expensive, but it can be tricky to find in any kind of quantity. Not a hell of a lot in here, is there? Mute fruit. You think a mute fruit you find in there would be pretty rubbish at this point. Ooh. Wasn't that cute? Eh, Bruce will take that. Yeah, that suits you. Not really. Not really at all. One thing of note, which I am a little bit wary of, bringing Valentine. Bruce doesn't know this. But companions have a tendency to, head down. Well, I should say their aiming might be off at times, and when it's off it can actually hit the player really, really, really hard. Especially on survival mode.
What's that?
I've got to be a little bit wary of that. Just... Yeah, okay. He burnt through all the ammo. Well done, Nick. Probably for the best, actually. Probably for the best. How's the health? Ribeye steak. That'll get the health ticking up. Not look quite like this, no. Not with these kind of buildings. Sorry, gonna... No, at least leave it to the Brotherhood. They can, Whoa! You guys are prompt. Yep, they can deal with that. Oh my gosh, really? We've got seat units out there as well. Air missiles. I don't even know what's going on anymore. Okay, I can guess what happened there. Legendary Raider, apparently. There you are. Return tokens again. Oh, the bloody explosions, alright. Sounds like I'm not a part of it at least, so... Shoot all they like. Oh, Valentine, he's, for all those comments about not being a fucking paid... Oh, there he goes.
Bingo.
Apparently I need to go heal him.
Lock tight.
Blast. Alright, let's go see about that. Alright, I suppose there is some haste involved. That was far further than I expected. Okay, let's get the health ticking back up. Okay, apparently... Valentine, where are you at? Over there. Oh, shit. I don't know what the heck he was fighting, so we gotta keep an eye out.
I hear something!
Gosh, barely see him. Okay, apparently Valentine's down here, so what does he need? What can I do for you, Valentine? I bet he doesn't take stim packs, does he? He takes that. Although I saw it in a chem station. Some kind of a robot healing thing. God damn it, he's got my Gatling gun. If I don't... Okay. Lighter companions. I have to wait for him to depart. He told him as he's leaving. And if I can't recruit him, then I have to at least get the stuff off him. Which is a... Also a pain in the ass. It might be a case where Bruce just goes on ahead and does this missing person case without him, sends him home to, I don't know, heal up or whatever. I'll try and catch him before then anyway, at least. Hopefully. But I can't heal you because I don't have access to anything to heal you with. I've got stim packs, but you won't take them because you're not a person, you're a synth. You're a robot. What else we got around here anyway? Killed a whole bunch of raiders. Hey. Good looking, kinda. Maybe not. I think it'll just be easier if we do have Nick with us. So, easier in the sense of like, he can do all the talking. There's no chem stations around here, is there? I don't think I can make one even if I wanted to. What a right pain in the ass you are. Is it because I'm in combat? No, I don't know. There is a way I can do it. Okay. If I enter here, and then come out again, he'll leave. And then I might be able to catch him before he gets back. Okay, see if we can catch him before he gets too far. Where is he? You son of a bitch, Nick Valentine, here come my Gatling laser. He's gone. Alright, we're gonna have to do it without him. Worthless hunk of bloody metal. It's doing you a goddamn favor doing this. This is how you bloody repay me. Fine. Okay, I heard Superman's over there, I think. Oh, for bloody... Jeez, looks like it was about to fall down. Probably is. I'm gonna give this a wide area, this area a wide berth. There it goes. Mildly peeved at Nick, not gonna lie. Mildly peeved. Feeling a bit put out, you might say. Okay, so we want to just get back on the road, head straight up north. We can at least check out this kind of thing. Maybe I've got a couple of Vitibur grenades, maybe we can go back and pick him up afterwards. But it looks like we're doing at least this stretch of the trip by ourselves. You're hostile? Maybe not.
Are you afraid of me?
Nope, you're hostile.
Because I'm going to kick your ass when I find you.
XO1 actually. I don't need the fusion cores. Bit not kill him. I'll try and kill him. Those things are pretty tough. And in a way, it wouldn't be very patriotic to to attack a army machine thing, given Bruce's backstory, history with the army. Without a Gatling laser, there's no point in carrying all these fusion cores. PC switch sucker jet running the shit away. Hello, this looks friendly. What's this? The slog. Hey guys, I brought friends. I brought company. Coward.
Welcome to the slog.
Yep. I got a death call to kill. Oh. Oh, it must be like his leash area. Okay, never mind. Scary. In that case... drop two, where's the other one? There it is. Oh shit. There we go. Let's get them all involved. Okay, there we go. Save up some ammo. Let them do all the work. Okay, this is a slog, I take it. Looks like everything's stealing. Nothing terribly interesting there, looks like it. Anyway, let's get going. It's been a long day already. Okay, if we just smoke across there... Oh, actually... Is that, we have something else up here. Yeah, here we go, special delivery. Yeah, just over there. Let's go talk to some guard captain. Let's go do that. I'm not sure if I will go back and get Nick. Like, to be perfectly honest, he's kind of a killjoy. Like, when we took the case to kill old Lannister, you know, he was all down on that. He's all been down on...
Just don't bring any trouble down on us.
What? Oh, like before, yeah. Yeah, I'll try not to lure any deathclaws here.
This place is off limits.
Well, I'll try to try.
Best to move along.
Let's see, Ebert said you might know, I need to know what happened to the missing package now. Good Deacon.
Edward Deegan sent me. I'm looking for a missing package.
Oh, you're the new guy. So this package, pretty sure we know where it is. The guys that shot Ben are holding
it. So why don't you go get it? Creamery. Cause the pain needed to get it. Okay. So all I needed,
to know.
Well then, I guess we're done.
Hey, guess we are.
Be careful. It's weird that they're still hanging
it's
around.
It's an assault rifle.
Normal raiders would have grabbed the loot and bugged out by now. Nice. It's like they're scouting the place or something.
Well,
I'll be glad when you clear them out.
Clear them out? No, I'm just gonna get the... whatever the hell it is, right? The package. You guys can worry about the rest of that. Rest of that stuff. I might as well do that on the way. No reason not to. Who are you? You're just, another mercenary guard. Okay, that's fine. Let's see, I think they said it was just up here, wasn't it? Wow. Apparently my pitbull knows. Recover the package. Yep, thumbs up. Go to the text. Whenever you're ready. There is no text, is there? Okay. Well, it's up here anyway. Evidently. Here's the courier. Sturdy leather. That's not too shabby. Not too shabby at all. Well done, you. Didn't save you, but... that must scale. I doubt if you come here at a lower level, it's too delicate. It'll be normal leather. Leather, leather, leather. So there's a bunch of raiders, wasn't there, scoping out the place. And they stole a package that was coming through.
What the?
Oh, shenanigans. They do damage. Shouldn't take them for granted. Holy Jesus. Let's pop another one. Let's pop some crikey dickery. She is wrecking me. Let's run for it, actually. I need to get my health back. Alright, I unloaded a lot of ammo into her, and she just did not care. Just gonna wait for that health to come back, then I'm gonna... I think I'll just jet run to her, to be honest. Bloody hell. She's getting closer. Maybe in a stroke grenade. Luckily she's highlighted on the map for some reason. There we go. Far out. She had a lot of stereo serum. Alright. What do you guys got? Pretty much... not much. Not much at all. A few water bottles around here. Just the three of them. Three of them came down and scoping out the place, huh? Yeah, whatever. Mysterious serum. I think it'll be packaged up like in a box or something. Very curious. No, never mind. That's not too bad. Same damage as my other combat rifle. Except it's got a night vision scope, which I'm not terribly fond of in general, but at night it actually works pretty well. Which I guess suddenly seems pretty obvious. No, I say it out loud. Are we going the right way? Yes, we are. Okay, let's get to the Nicano? I don't know. Residence. And then we'll I have to see what... Oh. Let's see if we can just run away from them. They take way too much ammo. I think we're going to be running there. Run. It's just ghouls, but ghouls can be a right pain in the behind. There's something glowing over there. That's another ghoul, isn't it? One of those funky glowing ghouls. There's, shivers, there's more of them. Put the sword away. That's it. Are we heading the right way? It's the only path. If they come this far, I'll just chop them down. Nah, looks like they're pissed off. Okay, we're all good. We're all good. Is it up here? I don't know, we're actually off the map. Okay, I guess we're just going to follow this road and see where it leads, and if it leads to dead end, we'll turn around. Yeah, what's raw roast? Raw rad roach meat. That's a little cooler. That's a nice house. And a boat. Nice. And, grave. I guess. Or maybe it's a monument. Maybe it's where they go.
Damn it! Come in! I know you're listening on the other end.
That was loud.
Where is she? Where is my daughter?
Kenji, please. You've been at this for hours. Stop. You need sleep.
She's out there, Ray. Someone has her. They could be raiders, or gunners, or God knows what else.
Kenji... Nakako, was it?
What? Who are you?
Naka.
I'm sorry, but we don't have time for visitors or caravans or wherever you're from.
With Valentine's Detective Agency, you asked for help.
I'm with Valentine's Detective Agency. You asked for help?
Oh, thank God. You have to get working right away.
Let's just get this over with.
It all started with this damn radio.
Our daughter Kasumi likes to fix things.
This whole talking thing tires Bruce out. Until she made these people are really shiny. Kidnapper
who lured her away from us.
I guess they're just oily.
She's not here especially. Anymore. Our daughter is 19. She knows how to survive, and she's capable. I think maybe she left because she wanted her own life.
No. She would have told us where she was going. She would have said something. I know my daughter.
I guess it makes sense. Like, there's no...
I can feel it.
Well, another episode. No, it's radiated water is the problem. You can't really just, like, go for a bath in the water there. And it's all about soap and stuff. Maybe they don't have any soap up here. Well, we're doing this for Nick, so he's gonna deal with the money side of things.
Hello?
Do you have any idea
so
where she could have gone?
I'm not gonna worry about
she took one of the boats,
trying to get the money off them.
All. She could be anywhere.
Never knows at home because I mean
I'll find her. Don't you worry.
Thank you. Her room is upstairs if that helps. And if you had any more questions about her, just ask.
Ah, my room covered. Save it, bourbon. Okay, ooh. That's right, because I'm working with you guys. Of course. Of course you won't mind if I help myself to a few essentials. This is the kind of payment the Bruce takes. Like, rather than trying to convince someone to pay him a couple of caps extra, just... It's easier just to go and take it, to be honest. Kasumi's project lamp. Project's lamp. Okay. I'm sure that's... Oh, empty bottle. Ah, I'm carrying so much again. Really? Yeah, carrying around a whole bunch of crap. Project radio? That's what she was talking about. He was talking about some kind of radio.
Project log? Radio. Correction. Working radio. I'll finally get some news outside this house. My handle is going to be... Let's go with...
Great. Teenage girl.
Ohm's Law. That should confuse the creeps. And if someone actually gets the reference, then we'll at least have circuitry in common.
Okay, so she's some kind of person who likes making stuff. Salisbury steak. Kitchen. Okay, so she's got a whole bunch of projects and she likes tinkering, I guess.
Nothing but static.
Okay. Well, you seem crazy. You seem calmer.
I suppose you have questions about my daughter.
You and your husband don't seem to agree where your daughter left. Tell me about this radio.
Tell me more about this radio your daughter was working on.
I remember Kasumi was very excited about it. I figured she was secretly trying to make contact with Diamond City or another settlement. We're pretty isolated out here. She only has us for company and
the ghouls.
Kenji can be overprotective.
I'd like to know more about Kasumi. Might shine. Oh, no, nothing else.
Nothing else right now.
Okay. Okay, let's go have a look around this place. I mean, we could go and grab Nick. He'll probably, like, he's the experienced guy. He's got the know-how of it. What was this, up here? It was. Holotape to Granddad. In loving memory of Tachi Nakano, grandfather sailor engineer. Let's give it a shot.
Granddad, I know you can't hear this, but
ooh.
I can't think of a better way to say goodbye.
Should probably put this one back.
So I won't forget any of it. I'm sorry that we'll never be able to fix up the old clunker we've got sitting in the boathouse. Wherever you are, I hope you're at peace.
Okay, so that must be the boathouse, and there's an old clunker in there that she was wanting to fix up. What's a clunker? It's like one of those things you... like a heavy nut, a heavy, like, heavy stone. Like, not a stone, but actual, but, like a piece of really hard fruit, like unripe fruit, which you tie some, you drill a hole through and you, like, tie string through, if I remember. Is that it? Or is that a conker? Yeah, it might be a conker, actually. Ah, they probably mean this boat. So what's wrong with the boat? I guess something's wrong with the boat. Well, Bruce wouldn't know what's wrong with that. Technical documents. In case we ever go back to the brother. Picture frame. Why can I examine this? This lovingly cared for picture of a lighthouse seems almost out of place, and really doesn't really seem out of place. Okay. So we have a key. What does a boat need that for? Grandfather's note. Dear Kasumi, if you ever get locked out of the safe, then the answer is here in the boathouse. Picture where the key is. Ah. Picture. That saves me trying to blow it open. Not very duct tape.
Project log? Myself. I never really thought about who or what I am, but God. Where do I start? The radio. I was right about the range. I managed to get a signal, a strong signal, from up north. There's a group of people up there. They say they're all synths. Synthetic people. Made by the Institute. They're trying to build a place for their kind. Where they can be themselves and be accepted for
Institute.
What they are alongside human beings. It sounds wonderful, but then they started asking about me and some questions came up.
So wild robots
I mean,
from the Institute
off, like I'm not really supposed to be here, but then
gone up north.
My childhood, I can't remember, and I've been having strange dreams.
She got in contact with them and she's hit up there as well. Okay.
To meet these synths, I have to know the truth about myself. They've told me to sail up north to a town called Far Harbor. I can make my way to them from there.
Alright, there we go. Mystery solved. Bruce, Master Detective. Let's see if we can drop that other holotape. It doesn't really seem right to drag it around with us when it's not really ours. Yeah, there you go. The other one's back as well. I don't really want to drag around some teenage girl's thoughts. There you go. It's a bit creepy.
Mr. Nakano.
Have you finished your investigation? Did you find anything?
Still looking though. No. Why would that even be there? I guess it means they can get out of the conversation. Should have had in brackets lie. I need to ask you...
I think I know where Kasumi went. A place called Far Harbor.
She went that far up north? God, that explains why she took the boat.
Wait, she took a boat?
There's no time to waste. You have to go after her.
Wait, did you find out why she left, Detective? Who she was speaking to?
What does it matter?
Because I know my daughter, and if she didn't tell us where she went, then she had a reason. Don't you want to know if she wants to be found?
You're right, Detective. Did you find any clue to why Kasumi left home?
Okay.
Your daughter made
no
contact
choice.
With a group of synths. She thinks she's one of them.
What? That's crazy.
She's not a synth. She's our daughter.
Hey, you guys. You guys asked.
I gave birth to her. She's flesh and blood, not a synthetic.
Don't bloody ask if you don't want to know.
Maybe your daughter is just confused, having an identity crisis.
Oh God, does she even think we're still her parents?
This is what I was afraid of. Someone twisting my daughter's mind.
Yep,
you have
it's terrible.
To get to Far Harbor. Take my ship on the dock. It has a guidance system, a final gift from my father, and it's built for distance.
Magic bird ride. Will we see monsters? That's crazy. I'm taking a ride on some rusty boat.
That's crazy. I'm not taking a ride on some rusty boat.
I trust that boat with my life. My father worked on it every day until he died. And it is all I can offer. Let me know if you change your mind.
Alright. But, goddammit, first I'm gonna go and get Nick Valentine. I don't want to do this by myself. If I'm going down in a rusty old ship, then I'm taking that bloody synth thing with me. For now we're going to have a quick smoke, and I think we're probably going to call it for this episode. In between, I'm going to head back to take a vertibird back to Diamond City. If there's someone out this far, I might have to go further in, I don't know. I'm going to pick up Nick Valentine. I'm going to see if I can get some of his magic stim packs, which he seems to like, which he doesn't like the normal ones. And I'm gonna drag him all the way, kicking and screaming back out here with my Gatling laser, which I want. And then we can both go on a bloody boat ride. Automated boat ride, apparently. Well, at least we don't have to steer it. You know that. I wouldn't trust Bruce to bloody steer a boat, so... Yeah, until then. Until next time.